Hey everyone, it's take a look at the clock here. It's 7:31 in the morning on Christmas Eve 2015. And as you can see, I'm doing a low-key Christmas tomorrow. But friends and family are welcome over, and I've been working at getting the house together for weeks. Every chance I get to clean and tidy up and organize, and as you can see, there's plenty of good food from Loblaws and lots of delicious President's Choice products. So, yeah, I definitely got everything together. So whoever comes over is going to have good food. And take a look at that. I'm up again to 23,150 PC Plus points. That means the next time I go shopping, I get another 20 bucks off my groceries. And already this year, I've already gotten $40 off. So my big project last night was cleaning the fridge, because let's just say I didn't want to take any pictures of it when it kind of was getting to the point where it looked like the black market eye transplant doctor from Minority Report. Remember that fridge with the fresh sandwich and then the rotten sandwich that Tom Cruise ate? It was kind of getting there, and I didn't want anyone going in the fridge and seeing that. It was pretty awful. But I even cleaned up the outside, and as you can see here, look at that, December 24th, 2015. It's been 2,493 days since I quit smoking cigarettes. The best decision I ever made. It was such a mistake to start. I'm still on the gum, even after all this time, but my health is way better than if I continued smoking and just make myself worse and worse. I think it was the right decision. It's the worst addiction in the world. You think it's the coolest thing when you're young, but when you get older and you realize how much it impacts your health, and your energy levels and your lung capacity, you realize how much of a ridiculously bad addiction it is. I mean, people can quit heroin, can quit crack, and they can quit meth, yet they still keep on smoking cigarettes. That tells you how bad it is. And look at that. Next week, I'll celebrate 2,500 days smoke-free. So let's take a look inside the fridge. This is where my event management training came in handy, making everything nice and organized. I don't know how I did this. This is mainly from those Pinty's wings, but I have enough hot sauce here to supply a small country for a year. Holy moly. But it's still good, so I kept it. I threw out the worst of the worst stuff. So everything is nice and neat, everything in its right place. Take a look at that. Look at that. Nice and neat fridge. Everything in its place. And as you can see, got a few things here. Got some Haagen-Dazs, and I got some yummy President's Choice products for Christmas Day for the friends and family who come over to Maison Blanche Nepean. So the shopping didn't take me all that long. Last night I went around 9:30 to the College Square, the Loblaws that I love going to, and it took me about half an hour to pick everything up, and then I only waited in the line for about 10 minutes, and there was only one person in front of me, and I got all my Christmas shopping done. I don't need to get anything more. I'm not buying gifts this year. Why get people gifts that they don't care about, don't appreciate, and I don't have the money for? I'm trying to eliminate all my debt rather than going back into more debt. So, you know, having plenty of good food, if hardly anyone comes, then I have more food for New Year's or for work, and it's stuff I would have gotten anyways. So I'm working Boxing Day, and I'm getting time and a half on the day after Christmas, and the government of Canada, thanks government of Canada, I really appreciate this, because I was poor last year. I get GST to begin the year, so that covers my groceries, and then I get my first pay of 2016 for all my overtime hours, first week of January. So everything's paid for, everything's done. It's gonna be a very stress-free, cool Christmas. I'm really looking forward to it no matter who comes. I've been working around the clock every chance I get. You probably have seen my videos where I tell you how many hours I've been putting into cleaning. But as you can see, take a look at that. Microwaves clean, counters clean. Got my pita with the hummus ready for everyone. Got my vitamins, Hulkamania style, where I put my training prayers and vitamins and being healthy. My pharmacist actually told me, take these vitamins because it'll make you feel better. And I've been taking them for weeks now, and I do notice a difference in my energy level, and I feel definitely a lot healthier. And yeah, everything is together. And look at this, the dining room is already almost ready. Here you go. These are the last five comic book hauls. I'm gonna get to that in a second, but I just wanted to take a look around. I spent a few hours doing it, but I called out all the comics and put them into long boxes, the ones that I didn't want to review. These ones I am going to review. So, as you can see, I got a lot of stuff to review, but I will get around to it. And I think that maybe looking at those particular issues at a different time with different eyes and different perspective will probably offer a better review. People certainly like my reviews of comics. If sometimes you can't get the issues or you want to learn more about them, people do like them. As you can see, I went hardcore collecting on the Secret Wars. And I have all sorts of stuff that I'm really looking forward to bringing to you on the Reverie Soul YouTube channel to review. I do have a stack of papers to read, but as you know, sometimes I have to work up because there's so much destruction and ridiculousness in the world. It does take me some time, but I do follow the news on Twitter and television and all other sources, but I probably will read that in one sitting. So I got all that to go. This is what I really look forward to. This was, I went to Staples. This is my agenda from last year. There's 1 week to go in it, and the best piece of advice I ever got from Joan Rivers' A Piece of Work documentary is you're doing all right as long as your agenda is full. And my agenda is damn full. There's always stuff in there. And I scored. I got the exact same agenda for next year. And it's the perfect one that I it has enough room to write in your information. And the way that it's organized is the way I like it. And as you can see, the Blu-ray and game and DVD library is all completely cleaned up. As you can see, Tinkerbell is waking up for her nap. Hey, Tinkerbell, how you doing, girl? Oh, look at that. What a majestic cat. Look how beautiful she is. Oh, yes, you're the most beautiful cat. She's my forever pet. She's a very good cat, but this I have to clean up when I get back to work. She has the cleanest coat. She always goes in her box. She comes back when she's called, when she goes outside. But look at this. She's an absolute pig when it comes to eating. She doesn't pee in the house. She does vomit from time to time when she eats too fast, but she always goes in her box. She always comes when she's called. She has an excellent personality, and I chose her to be my cat. She's my very first pet. I'm responsible for her life. And the only negative that she really has, besides sometimes just being very demanding, because I think she was a goddess in a previous life, is that she is a bit of a messy eater. And that's okay. No one's perfect and no cat is perfect. But as far as cats go, she's as good as it gets. And when I get cloned, if I die before I finish the things that I have to do in this life, I've taken measures to ensure that she will be cloned too. And she'll be with me as long as I'm on the earth. So, and to tell you the truth, she'll be with me in the life beyond. Actually different in multiple versions of her, from the template to variations. where I'm going in the afterlife. There's gonna be a lot of the Tinkerbell population to keep me company, along with my soul bond wife. So this is it. Everything's together, everything's sorted. Thanks to my mother, I had my Christmas lights up. As you can see, it's a green Christmas in Ottawa. It's looking a little dismal out there, but everything's positive inside Maison Blanche. And thanks to my mom, she set up a little Christmas tree for me. I did pick up at Marshall's, I saw this sort of Buddhist head. It looks kind of clubby and interesting. So I said, hey, why not? I'll get that. It was only $15. So I got everything together, and they did have a contest where you could win your purchase. So, hey, for 15 bucks and I had cash, how could I say no to that? Nice piece of interesting art. And look at this, I got everything together. I'm gonna do my final bit of tidying tonight. Got plenty of chips. As you can see, the only thing that I wasn't able to afford was back in my party days, I did not have my guests treat my furniture well, and the upholstery looks awful, but I should be able to afford it in a few weeks. I found a place on Colonnade in Ottawa, just close by. I like to support the local economy, and they actually gave me quite a reasonable rate to do the reupholstery, so that's in the works. I'll probably make a video when I get it together, because I've waited years to do this. But then again, I'm on shift today. It'll be shift 61 at my full-time permanent job that relates to my education and goes very well, and my marks are very high on it. I even had the bigger boss and big boss shake my hand yesterday, and we exchanged greetings for the holidays and Christmas. And that was very gratifying, because they know how much I've worked hard to improve and how seriously I take my duties. And it's nice to see your metrics prove that you actually do good work, because I've worked in jobs before where I've said I've done certain things, but I don't think they really took it down and took note of it. Or I don't think that they really appreciate the work that I really did. And I feel where I'm at now, they need me and they do appreciate my work. So I'm very happy about that. So all of these together, I'm gonna take my time over the next few weeks and get around to doing some reviews. But this is it. After today, I'm gonna work. I'm gonna be back around a little later this evening, and maybe 2 hours at most to finish everything off. And Tinkerbell just loves her new blanket. She loves soft things. And she's been a really good cat to me. She's been a good friend. And she's a very loving cat. When I sit back and she jumps up now on my lap, and then she stands on me, like on my chest, as if she is like assuming her authority over me. Well, she is the empress, and she is the goddess, and she is the lady of the house until I find a special someone to be the lady and official first lady of Maison Blanche Nepean. And as you can see here, if you're ever looking for someone to put together an event for you, I am in the MPI Ottawa chapter directory. You can find me in there if you know who I am. And I'm always gonna stick with MPI. They're a good organization. They do great things. And for all my hard work, I graduated both hospitality management and event management at Algonquin College, and it was life altering. I went from being below the poverty line. I don't claim to have the greatest job now, but I'm almost at a middle class level. And that's in only 4 years of putting together a career. So that's a lot in a short space of time. I didn't really have any real direction before that, but I made a choice to get my act together and to work very hard and be responsible. If I'm gonna be the one issuing directives and commands and asking people to do as I ask, then I better walk the walk, so that I can talk the talk. And I definitely do a lot of work for everyone that I know. So everyone, I'm gonna get now to the last five hauls. This is the Christmas edition, and I'm gonna bring you up to speed as to what I picked up in the last 5 weeks. And I think you're gonna enjoy what my selections are. So I'll get to it. And thank you again for everyone who's tuned in to this video and the Reverie Soul YouTube channel, where there's a variety of different things. I don't try to stick with one type of video. I like to experiment, even if I'm wrong, even if I am not trying to get the most attractive number of views. At least I try, and at least I'm genuine, and at least I put stuff out there, and at least I devote my life to learning, experiencing, so that I can create the new existence, the afterlife to come. Comic books are one part of that. And certainly I devote my time, I work to pay the bills, and I create art for the soul. And videos on YouTube is creating art for the soul. I mean, you might not think of it as art, but to me it is. And comic books, look, I went on a path of being in hell and inflicting much harm upon myself, and comic books saved my life. I made a decision that I was gonna start get back into collecting, and I started off with getting one X-Men title a month, and I moved to Nepean, which was probably the best ever thing to ever happen to me. And of course, I live two blocks away from the comic book shop on Clyde and Nepean. I love the staff, I love the store. They always fulfill my requests. They always get what I need. They're always happy to help me out. They're very passionate, and I thank them greatly. Thank you so much, comic book shop on Clyde and Nepean. You guys are awesome. I love to support the local economy here in Nepean, especially all the shops along Merivale and other places. And I'm really glad that I live so close by to a comic book shop. And it is expensive in terms of a hobby, but it empowers me, it inspires me, it makes me work harder and make more. Hey everyone, this is Darryl Christopher coming at you from Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. It is December 24th, 2015. It's Christmas Eve, and in spite of belonging to a, I guess you could say, neutral class, tangent, alternate belief system that is my faith and religion, I do celebrate Christmas. And I think no matter what you believe, whether you're Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh, Confucian, Shinto, atheist, I think that Christmas is a celebration that no matter what you believe, is a celebration for all of mankind. And no matter what, I don't care that people think that it's pushing Christianity on the rest of people. I think that enough harm has been done to Christianity by the anti-Christian forces in the world. Those possessed by evil and destruction and that live for death, those within the faith that take what was written 2,000 years ago literally rather than the example. Let me tell you something. I am pro every race. I'm pro black, I'm pro Asian, I'm pro indigenous, I'm pro Caucasian, I'm pro everyone. And I'm pro gay, lesbian, two-spirited, trans, whatever you want to be, that's fine with me. Unlike the Bible, which condoned slavery, I'm absolutely against it. I believe in the equality of mankind, wealth for all, and I'm driven by the mandate while I'm on earth to make a difference, make the earth a better place, and leave the earth better than I found it. And I do look tired. I've been working all night to get everything together, so I think now I got about 2 hours at most left to do when I get home, so I'm gonna work. Yes, I do function very well without sleep. I probably wouldn't after another day, but I can get away with it today. I'm gonna take a nap, I'm gonna relax, and everything is gonna be done for tomorrow. And I'm gonna enjoy the day with my friends and family, whoever wants to drop by to Maison Blanche Nepean. And to everyone out there, I wish you a very happy and very merry and awesome Merry Christmas. Because no matter who you are and what you believe, the Lord taught us that anything is possible, that He made it real to become divine, and that every human being has the power to alter reality. And no matter what you believe, that's a pretty awesome teaching. So if you use this life to learn, to experience, to grow, adapt, evolve, and move on, then you won't be trapped in the cycle, and you can evolve into the ultimate endpoint of humanity, which is the divine, and that is the entirety of all that is, and you can experience what it is to consist of galaxies, universe, planets, dimensions, etc., etc., and understand the big everything, the big nothing, and everything in between that makes all that is. So anyways, enough religious talk and spiritual talk for you. I believe what I believe, and I'm not going to make you believe what I believe. I don't want you to follow what I follow or do as I say, but I do provide an option, and I just thought I'd let you know. That's it. That's all. Anyways, I know what you're here for. If you do watch my videos and you come back to my channel, then you're here to watch a video about comic books. And enough of the delay. Let's get down to it. So we start off from a new comic book day for November 25th, 2015. And here on the cover of Comic Shop News, issue 1485, is Deja Thoris. Very interesting. So what did I get? I guess that would be 5 weeks ago. Well, I got issue number 7 of Fight Club 2. Right on. We have the ultimate amazing conclusion from Kaboom of Over the Garden Wall, issue 4 of 4. This was actually every issue got better and better, and by far the best issue was issue 4, and I'll let you know a little later when I do my review. Oh, here we go. Hail Hydra. We have issue number 4 of the Secret Wars tie-in Hail Hydra, starring Captain America's adopted son. Oh, right on. We have the subcover, issue number 36 from IDW of My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic. Hey, everyone has a sensitive soft side to them, and everyone loves My Little Pony. For all you lovers of Adventure Time and card games, we have from Kaboom, issue 5 of 6 of Adventure Time with Fiona and Cake, Card Wars. This is getting down to the nitty gritty, so I'll tell you more later on in videos to come. For all you Star Wars fans, and let me tell you a little bit of something about Star Wars. I was a little boy taken to the movies in Toronto to a 70mm screen back when they had smoking in the theater, and Star Wars was the movie that began my life in terms of I was damaged and broken as a young child. But Star Wars was the compensation, the reward, the gift that bound so many things with families and friends and loves together, and my belief in the future. I know Star Wars was set in the past, but as they said in the Family Guy parodies, yet somehow it is the future. And I'm not rushing out to see the movie in the theater, but when I do see it, they have a, in Ottawa, they have a VIP theater at Lansdowne, and we're gonna do it proper because I never go to the movies. I don't like spending money to go to the movies and then buy it on Blu-ray and then watch it at home and spend the money twice. But for Star Wars, I'm gonna do it, and I'm gonna let you know, there was a very special someone in my life and still in my life and very much a part of me. And I wanna make a special shout out to my best ex-girlfriend ever, Jennifer Payne, who every day this month I've certainly thought of. And our initial plan when we were together was to see the movie together. And certainly we will one day in real life, no matter what. She will come to the afterlife with me. And I did just have a dream the other night that she got married. So I was really happy about that. And it was kind of bittersweet because I do have a lot of feelings for her, but at the same time, I do want her to be happy. And I think that if we were closer and in a parallel universe, we certainly would have gotten everything together and everything would have worked out happily ever after. But all I can say is she's absolutely one of the best people, one of the best women in the entire world. And I just wanted to say that and let her know, because sometimes I don't say much, but certainly she has, ever since we started corresponding, she's been a part of my life. And because of Star Wars, I, in the last little while, I've certainly thought of her pretty much every day. So special shout out to Jennifer Payne. And here we go. We have from Star Wars, issue number 8 of Kanan. As you know, he's the Padawan who survived the Clone Wars and now is on Star Wars Rebels on Disney XD. So there you have it. Oh, here you go. I heard the movie wasn't that great. I'm gonna see it for myself. I was really hoping that it would be awesome, so I'm hoping it's not going to be a letdown. But here you go. We have issue number 9 of Gem and the Holograms, and this series just keeps on getting better and better. One of the best reads out there. If you love Gem and the Holograms, I am completely 100% totally hetero in my 40s, but in the 80s, Gem was pretty damn awesome. And to reconnect with Gem after all these years and have totally awesome stories about her and the holograms and the misfits, I'm telling you, it is pure awesome. So check it out if you have not already. Oh, here we go. One of my highest rated series. You've probably seen my video about it. Invisible Republic, if you haven't checked this out. One of the best series by far out there. One of the best from Image. We have issue number 7 of Invisible Republic. Very cool. More Star Wars action, of course. We have Star Wars Chewbacca, issue number 4. Oh, for the new school Star Trek, we have issue number 51. Of Star Trek from IDW. Very cool stuff. If you're waiting for the next movie and you want to have some Star Trek stories with the J.J. Abrams style crew, check this out. Oh, this guy always goes to the top of my file, top of my pile, I should say, my reading pile. I have issue number 13 of Star Wars Darth Vader. One of my all-time favorite novel and story series from Stephen King. We have the Marvel adaptation from Stephen King of The Dark Tower. Drawing of 3, and this is issue 3 of 5 of The Lady of Shadows. Check it out. Oh, here we go. We have, if you love Snake Plissken, we have issue number 12 of Escape from New York. Surprisingly, I did not see Escape from New York, not in the 80s, but I saw it many decades later, and I thought, wow, how did I ever miss this? This is one of the most awesome movies ever. And this series continues where it all left off, and it's totally awesome. So check it out. Here's a new series I started to get into from Top Cow. We have issue number 8 of Postal. Very interesting series you have to check out. So we move on now to New Comic Book Day for December 2nd, 2015. And I actually did add this series to my sub on the cover for issue 1486 of Comic Shop News. We have the new series, Symmetry. I haven't started reading yet, but I'm looking forward to it. So what did I get this week? 4 weeks ago, we have Star Wars issue number 13. Wow, hard to believe that Marvel has been putting out 13 issues of the official canon Star Wars for over a year now. Wow, ever since I got it back from Dark Horse, and Dark Horse set such a high standard, and then Marvel delivered. I have not been disappointed at all with Star Wars titles in terms from Marvel. I used to collect, that was the only subscription I had when I was a young boy to Marvel, was the Star Wars series back in the day. And by far, this is above and beyond, way better. I haven't started collecting a lot of the new series from Marvel and where they decided to go after Secret Wars. But one of the series I do collect is The Invincible Iron Man. We have issue number 4 here, and as you can see, Tony Stark Iron Man meets up with Mary Jane Watson. Wow, this is something. Here's one of my favorite and most underrated Avengers. We have Black Knight number 1. I got this to check out. We have the Ultimates issue number 1 for 2015. Another one of my favorites from Kaboom. We have issue number 30 of the regular show. Oh, and did you know that the name Atlan, the name of the civilization, the Imperium of my creations, is based upon my first comic book that I ever got, Peter Parker, Spectacular Spider-Man number 11, and in it, the guest was Medusa of the Inhumans from Atlan, and that's how I got Atlan, and that's how it all began. So here you go. I had to say yes to this. We have issue number 1 of the all new Inhumans. Another series I decided to follow. I used to follow it back in the day, and I really enjoyed it a lot. I'm really glad I started to follow the new series. We have issue number 3 of Doctor Strange. Here's a series that has not disappointed at all. James Bond 007. And this is more like the James Bond from the novels rather than the movies. And I'll tell you what, it's been an awesome read thus far. I highly recommend, if you like James Bond, and not just Daniel Craig, and not just all the Sean Connery and Roger Moore and Timothy Dalton and Pierce Brosnan. This is the real deal. Check it out. Here's one that's rather interesting from Vertigo, based upon the social media age that we now live in. We have issue number 2 of Unfollow. And to round things out, I have the subcover here, issue number 23 of My Little Pony Friends Forever, because one series from My Little Pony is just not enough. Okay, So this is where I get to 3 weeks ago for a new comic book day, December 9th, 2015. We have a feature article on issue number 1487 of Comic Shop News. We have Shaft, Imitation of Life. Shaft is a pretty awesome read, by the way. And for the week of December 9th, 2015, we have, well, what do we have here? The subcover, issue number 37 from IDW, My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic. Here's one that they that I thought would be a rather interesting read, and we have issue number 1 from Vertigo of Lucifer. Here's a superhero team that has always had a special place in my heart, kind of in the same way that when I was watching the WWE, back when it used to be the WWF, I also used to have a special place in my heart for WCW, and in a way this kind of is the WCW of superhero teams. Similar, yet very different, very interesting reads all the time, from the original limited series to their guest appearances. We have the new 2015 series, issue number 1 of the Squadron Supreme. Right on. We have here issue number 4 of 5 of the Dark Tower, Drawing of the Three, The Lady of Shadows. Right on. Go, Stephen King. Here we have issue number 2 of the All New Inhumans. Secret Wars is finally wrapping up. Wow, how many months after Convergence? Wow. We have issue number 5 of the Secret Wars tie-in Ultimate End. We have the epic conclusion of Adventure Time with Fiona and Cake, Card Wars, issue 6 of 6. Oh, never disappoints, always gets better. We have the holiday special for Gem and the Holograms, great stuff from IDW. This is the year 2015, the year of Star Wars. We have Darth Vader Annual number 1. And to round things out for the week of December 9th, we have issue 9 of Star Wars Canon. Right on. So, here we go. We're getting closer to where we're at now. And look at this for the week. New comic book day for December 16th, 2015. Oh, hard to believe it's almost over after all this time. Issue number 8 of Secret Wars. And then you know the next issue, issue number 9 to round things out, is going to blow your mind. It's going to be awesome. So I'm really looking forward to it. Secret Wars has been an... Okay, and look at what we have here. We have Star Wars Annual 1 from Marvel. Right on. Very good read. Oh, we're leading up to the big story in issue number 150. Here we go. We have issue 149 of The Walking Dead. Big stuff happening. I won't tell you, but trust me, if you read it, you know what I'm talking about. Here we go. We have the epic conclusion of Star Trek Green Lantern, The Spectrum War. And this is issue 6 of 6. This was actually a pretty enjoyable read. I'll let you know more when I review it. Now, when I was growing up in the 80s, there's one series that I never collected that I really wanted to collect, and I never got, and I always felt like it was missing from my life, but leave it to Marvel to bring back something that was from the past and bring it into the present day. We have issue number 3. This is the variant cover of Contest of Champions. Rather interesting stuff. Here we go. We got the Archie style cover from issue number 52 of Star Trek. And now we get to the comic books that I have yet to read. So everything from here on out, this is what I'm going to enjoy on Christmas Day after I do get in my nap. So I have issue number 3 of Grumpy Cat, along with Pokey, of course. We have issue number 47 of Adventure Time. Oh, this has got to be good. We have the 2015 My Little Pony Holiday Special. And I got the first issue of this one because it was big and the art looked awesome and the cover looked awesome and I was not disappointed by what was inside. Here you go. We have issue number 2 of Monstrous. Very cool stuff from Image. I highly recommend you check it out. We have issue number 3 of Spider-Gwen. Who knows, she would blow up and be as hot as she is as a character. Go Gwen. All right. We have the Gwenpool Holiday Special. Oh, here we go. We have issue number 2 from Dynamite. Pathfinder Hollow Mountain. And here's the one that I picked up based upon the cover alone and in addition to the feature article in Comic Shop News. I am really looking forward to checking this out. I'll let you know what I think. We have issue number 1 of Symmetry. And now, this is the haul for yesterday, December 23rd, 2015. And once more, a big, big thanks to my special friends, good people at the comic book shop on Clyde and Nepean, who hooked me up with all my needs and get me what I'm looking for. So I very much appreciate their help and assistance in my comic book world. And they're awesome people, and I just wanted to say a very special Christmas to them, a very Merry Christmas. Happy New Year, all the best. I look forward to being back next week with them. And for December 23rd, 2015, the new comic book day that it was, we have issue 1488 of the Comic Shop News, and we have Twilight Zone 1959 on the cover, so that should be interesting. I have yet to check that one out even. That's how busy I've been. Oh, here we go. We have issue number 8 from Dark Horse. We have Fight Club 2, number 8. Oh, this has got to be good. We have issue number 14 of Star Wars Darth Vader. We have issue number 13 of Escape from New York. This is a series that I got into a little later, but surprisingly I connected rather well with it considering my self-destructive path of the past when I was a lost soul and in deep pain and deservedly having to serve my time in hell. And thankfully I survived it all and now my life is pretty damn awesome. We have issue number 17 of Deadly Class. Oh, one of my all-time favorites. We have issue number 8 of Invisible Republic. Pretty damn awesome. Best of the best kind of stuff from Image. Oh, X-Files is coming back to TV pretty soon. I've already seen the promo shots on the adverts on TV. So check it out. We have the X-Files 2015 Xmas Special. Right on. This one appealed to me on the cover alone, so I decided to add it to my sub, but I heard that it's going to be a good read. We got issue number 1 of Venus. And one of the few new Marvel, retooled new Marvel Universe series that I decided to pick up. It's nice to see Peter Parker making some money and doing well. And having a good life and interesting adventures. We have issue number 5 of The Amazing Spider-Man. And they did have some 50% off issues, and I'm not all about the Marvel. I do have some love for DC, and I certainly do not say no to it or no hate on my part. So I picked up issue number 8 of Convergence. I got Futures End, Batman and Superman number 1. I got Superman Futures End Action Comics number 1. I got Futures End Earth 2 number 1. because I'm doing so well and because it is Christmas time and I work hard, I've been working long hours, 9.5 hour shifts every day, and it's been very busy, very stressful. I think tomorrow, Christmas Day, when I'm chilling with the family and the friends, this is what I'm gonna enjoy. I got this pretty awesome epic collection here of awesome classic X-Men issues. So I got this epic collection of the X-Men from a lot of issues that where I wasn't collecting them, and I knew they had good stuff, and now I finally get to revisit the ones that I've read and learn and read the ones that I missed and came before my time. So right on, I'm really looking forward to this. And I know Walking Dead is coming back to TV. Things are pretty crazy, the way they left things in the mid-season finale. But in terms of how I'm gonna spend my Walking Dead time, every Sunday is Walking Dead Day. But I am catching up to what happened in the comic books to the point where I started collecting. So I decided to splurge a little bit, and I got the next volume in The Walking Dead that I've been reading. So I have volume 8 here of The Walking Dead. As you know, more sex, more violence, more swearing, far more intricate and interesting story than TV, but the TV series is awesome. So is Fear the Walking Dead. So I have volume 8 here. And obviously I got the wrong order here. I got volume 7. And now I'm gonna start with volume 7, go into volume 8, and save up a little money, and then get volume 9. So slowly but surely, I'm catching up with the rest of the human race. Anyways, like I said before, everyone, no matter what you believe, I wish you all, every human being, the star people, our space brothers and sisters, I wish everyone in this entire universe, existence, all dimensions, parallel universe, alternate realities, I wish you all a damn fine, merry, merry, super awesome, Merry Christmas, everyone. Take care. I'll see you next time on the Reverie Soul YouTube channel. I'm your host, Darryl Christopher. It's been an amazing year for the Reverie Soul channel. And stay tuned for more videos to come. And thank you, as always, to the awesome subscribers, people bored at work and willing to watch anything, random YouTube lovers, and people who just enjoy my videos. No matter who you are, why you're watching, thank you so much for your time, everyone. Take care, and until next time. Bye-bye.